day three, your first time in half pads. I like how the competition level keeps going up every day. Worked some situational work today, third down, end of half, at the end of practice. And it's fun to see, you know, really two groups that are executing both sides of the ball fairly decently, probably as good as we have in our four camps here. Still got a ton to do, a long way to go, but we've got some guys that understand the tempo of what we're trying to do things and are out here making plays and competing, so it's fun to see.
Coach Bo was on the hill doing rehab work. Is that precautionary?
Yeah, he's got a strain, and so we know what he can do. We wanted to work Vasquez in at center, see what he could do there, so it just creates more reps for these younger guys.
Coach, your assessment of the quarterbacks today?
It's kind of like every day, a little good, a little bad. We worked Ford in a little bit, some of our base stuff. He's a little behind the others just because, he was taking the class, so he wasn't there the first day install. But we're going to continue to get him reps. I think he's going to have a chance to compete.
Is that why he wasn't in on the 11-on-11, the team drills?
Yeah, it's hard when you don't know the offense going in and you're the quarterback. So, no punishment. It's just, we got to get him caught up to speed.
So we'll be a day behind on half pads and a day behind on full pads.
Yeah, tomorrow he'll be out here in half pads with everybody else. And then when we go full pads, you got to do another day of half pads. Which for our quarterbacks, they can be half pads every day. We're not going to hit them.
What's your assessment, just the progress of the defense compared to the offense right now, early in camp?
I think both sides of the ball, we're far from a finished product. We're getting more consistent on not giving up big plays. And when our offense is doing it, they're having to make a play. It's not just somebody running free behind our guys. So that's encouraging to see. Our young guys are still going to give some busts, but our older guys are much more consistent. I think even though we're in a half-padded practice today, our guys physically got after each other, which was fun to see.
The young guys picking it up real well?
Yeah, it's typical young guy stuff. A lot of enthusiasm. We just got to refine the execution. But we certainly have some talent in that group. We got some length in that group. And the future is very, very bright.
It's only been 3 days, but have any of them kind of stood out to you so far, or any plays?
It's hard because we still haven't gone full pads and we're not tackling to the ground. But there's quite a few guys that stand out. You look at on the defense, I thought James Bailey did some things flying around today that impressed some people, opened some eyes. I think just body presence wise, LJ is going to be a force out there. He's got to learn how we do things all the time consistently. But, every day, one of those young guys, kind of stands out. It's like, ooh, this guy's going to be a really good player.
How close do you think the team is to really establishing its identity?
We're still 26 practices away. It gets established probably about halfway through, three-quarters way through camp.
Okay.
And then once we get into the season, there's going to be ups and downs. Our team wasn't defined after three games last year. Mm-hmm. I'm still trying to figure out the definition of last year's team, but we're a little psychotic. But after three games, nobody gave us a plum, nick. But our guys got off the mat and competed in our league. Not consistently, but enough to where we won our division. So, we're a year older at a lot of positions, much more depth. But I like the work ethic of this team. It's developing a harder edge than I thought than we were at this point a year ago.
You alluded to the intensity of practicing. How's that KO with you spring for a few days of now? Do you like the way it's going, the aggression?
Absolutely. I think anytime you have guys that are older, that are not learning and hesitant because they don't know what to do, you get a chance to play more aggressively. You play faster. And when you have guys that play with a chip on their shoulder, like I want our guys to play, sometimes it's going to spill over. We got to have a balance between playing right on that edge but staying on this side of it. At times it's going to spill over in practice, and we got to teach guys where to dial it back and when to keep pressing.